State Representative Randy Peitzman calls the issue of sex offenders a crisis and hopes his bill can help deal with the problem. Authorities here at the Lincoln County Sheriff's Department know all too well about sex offenders. They have more sex offenders per capita than several other counties in our area. They call Peitzman's efforts a strong beginning.
My bill basically, I call it, goes after the worst of the worst sex offenders.
Missouri State Representative Randy Peitzman talking about his bill, House Bill 114, would require anyone convicted of child molestation in the first degree to wear an electronic monitor when they move from one county to another. Sex offenders have 72 hours to register with law enforcement in their new county. Once they are in compliance, the monitor can be removed.
It keeps track of them, so we don't have to spend the resources to do it. It's to free up finances for counties like Lincoln County that they don't have to go looking for these people. So it's just gonna make it a lot easier for them to do their job.
Peitzman says he tried to get the bill passed before, but it didn't happen. Now could be the time. He points to our recent report detailing the high number of sex offenders in Lincoln County and the high amount of sex crime investigations at the Lincoln County Sheriff's Department as reasons why his bill is important.
To me, this is an epidemic in our state. It's not so much just about these, the worst of the worst offenders, but all of them. It's on a rise in our state.
Lieutenant Andy Binder with the Lincoln County Sheriff's Department says the department supports House Bill 114. Binder believes the bill is the first step to solving the larger problem of tracking sex offenders.
It gets the conversation going, especially when we're dealing with our state reps and our senators, to maybe build on this. It's a great building block. Would we like to see it bigger? Yeah, absolutely we'd like to see it bigger, but this is a great starting space. It's a small step in a very large problem, but at least we're trying to make progress in the right direction.
Hopefully this is just the beginning, because there's so much more to it.
Peitzman's bill is scheduled for a hearing on February 4th before the Crime Prevention and Public Safety Committee. Peitzman hopes to get his bill out of committee, then on to a full vote before the House and Senate. Reporting in Troy, Chris Fernier, Fox 2 News.